What's up, guys? Welcome back. We're kicking off May with Probing Paul, episode number 93. This is my monthly Q&A series that I usually do every month. Sometimes I skip a month or two. I don't know about you guys, but I've been feeling like I want to kind of dial things back a little bit. I want to simplify. I want to keep things easy, straightforward, and easily digestible. So that is the theme I've gone with for today's questions, which are all in the timestamps below. Let's get started.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise, tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. Actually, let's start by explaining how this works. There is a Probing Paul playlist where you can go back and see all the times I've been probed in the past. I should switch back to light mode. You can't even see the light mode episodes back there anymore. I usually pick the questions I'm going to answer from the comments of the previous video, but when it's been a couple months, I'll also delve into the comment sections of other videos, which is what I did today. We're going to start off with our first question from Mr. Jason Cinco, who says, I'm due to build a new PC this summer. Do I jump now or do I wait? Are things going to get better or worse? This is the consummate question when it comes to building your own gaming PC, and I'm gonna answer three ways. The way it used to be, the way it is now, and my actual advice. And if you wanna jump straight to that, my actual advice is, I don't know. And anyone who says that they do know is just blowing smoke into one of your orifices. This used to be a much simpler question to answer, though. The answer used to be, just buy now. Go ahead and buy if you want a new gaming PC, because there's always gonna be new stuff coming out. Your system is going to become obsolete, or I shouldn't say obsolete, your system is going to drop back from the bleeding edge of technology over time. Just go ahead and buy and start using your computer, because if you don't buy a computer, then you're missing out on using your new computer in the time between now and when you actually do decide to buy. Because that fear that you're gonna make a purchase and then something new is gonna come out that made your purchase seem like a bad idea or a bad choice by comparison is just something that you have to learn to live with as a builder of PCs. But that was how it used to be, I would say 10 plus years ago when it came to PC building. In more recent years, 5 to 10 years of the past, things have changed quite a bit, and there have become a lot of outside influences that affect the prices of PC hardware. Cryptocurrency mining was one of the first that popped up. That came in a couple waves. It was an outside influence on the price of PC hardware, most specifically GPUs, but that affected the entire price of a PC that you might want to put together. Fortunately, the demand for gaming graphics cards, specifically for cryptocurrency mining, has pretty much dissipated, but that has been largely replaced by a new demand for AI usage, and unfortunately that affects not just the GPUs that are available at retail, but also in decisions as to how to allocate fab capacity, decisions made by Nvidia and AMD when it comes to the amount of wafers they have available from a fab they're doing business with, which is pretty much TSMC right now, and how many of those wafers that get spit out, which are GPUs designed for AI use or GPUs designed for gaming graphics cards. And it's pretty evident right now that they're putting their money where they're making the most profit, which is in AI. And now in 2025, we have another outside factor influencing the prices of PC hardware, and that is tariffs, primarily here in the US, but it seems to be having a knock-on effect in other areas of the world as well. And the frustrating thing about the tariffs has been their inconsistency. It's very difficult to predict what's going to happen tomorrow or next week or in a month with the tariff situation, if there are going to be exemptions made for certain categories of products. That is just a huge question mark that nobody really knows the answer to, apparently, except the people who are making those decisions. So getting to the third part of my answer and my actual advice, rather than just offering a shrug and be like, I don't know. But that would be, if you're in the market to buy a new computer, to stay savvy about the pricing. Know what the prices should be versus what the prices actually are. And I do have a regular series called Build Fix, where I go over builds submitted by viewers and I say my advice on what is good and what is not good and where parts should maybe be swapped out. So consider that as a potential resource or stepping off point to get an idea of what the prices should be. And then as you're looking at the actual market and actual prices, you'll be better positioned to determine maybe a 5 to 10% markup for a product you know is in short supply right now. That might be a reasonable buy versus something that's 25, 30, 40, or 50% marked up, which you should probably hold off on. And then I guess the last part of my answer would be to do what I sometimes do and just to, for no real reason at all, just try to be hopeful. Try to be hopeful and optimistic. Maybe things will get better. Speaking of things getting better, my next question is from Chris Bork 8692, who is a channel member for 6 months. Thank you very much, Chris, for your support there, and thank you for this question that you might not remember asking. What PC games have you actually been playing lately? I have actually been playing more PC games recently than prior to that, not to be too vague about it or anything, but I've been doing a lot of PC gaming recently with my daughter, Hannah. She has absolutely come to love Minecraft in the past few months. She's become a little bit infatuated with it. We went and saw the Minecraft movie. Fortunately, it was before the chicken jockey thing became like a phenomenon, so we were able to watch it in relative peace, which was nice. But you guys might have seen my recent build or rebuild of the white system that I put in the living room, and that has been up and running and functional and doing a great job. So Hannah will play Minecraft on that computer while I also join her playing Minecraft on my Asus ROG Ally. We recently also tried out It Takes Two, which is a two-player co-op game, which is just really good, very fun, very unique and challenging. And I feel like it's just challenging enough for her that she can sort of figure things out as she goes along. And it's like a challenge level that she doesn't get in Minecraft creative mode, where I have to be like, oh, why don't you switch to survival? And she's like, no, I like creative. But in It Takes Two, there is no creative mode, so we both just play together, and that's been a lot of fun. And then most recently, much to the delight of my wife, she has started to play Overwatch. My wife has been showing her Overwatch videos for quite some time, because Overwatch has some awesome cinematics that they've made throughout the years. But I think it's thanks to using mouse and keyboard to navigate around Minecraft that made Hannah comfortable enough with the FPS style gameplay that we've been jumping into Overwatch. It started out with us just doing a custom game so she could kind of wander around the maps and explore, but then we started to add AI bots so we actually had someone to fight against, and we've gotten to the point now where we add a couple AIs to our team and populate the other team with AI, and we're still just playing with beginners, so it's fairly simple. But she really loves playing the game, doing the escort. She's been trying a bunch of different types of characters, and it's really fun to watch her learn and know the characters and recognize their voice lines and everything. And yes, the new HTPC out there in the living room has been doing a great job for that. So we've been super happy, and game time in the afternoons has become a very favorite part of the day, I think, for Hannah. All right, my last question slash comment is from Zero Bulin Me, who asked several different questions via a couple comments. So I'm gonna go through this and answer them. They're all pretty good starter PC building questions, but they're looking at building a PC as a present to themselves for their 30th birthday with a budget of 3K, which is a pretty solid budget, but yeah, you're not gonna get quite as much for your money as you would have recently, but let's answer the questions. Is thermal paste universal? That is an interesting question. There's lots of different kinds of thermal paste. There's different formulas for different types of paste, going all the way up to liquid metal, and there's even like thermal pads now that you can use as a replacement for thermal paste. There are some paste and solutions that work better than others. There's usually only a 2, 3, or 4 degree difference going from something that's not as good to something that's really good. So I wouldn't worry too much about your choice of thermal paste. The little individual tubes that come with CPU coolers are perfectly fine to use. I would say just don't mix thermal pastes. Make sure if you're replacing thermal paste, clean off all of the old thermal paste first using rubbing alcohol or similar solution before you reapply new paste. Next, would it be better to prioritize a GPU or CPU for a multi-use machine that's somewhat future-proof for recording and streaming of gameplay with the emphasis on quality performance? Looking at a Ryzen 7 9800, maybe a 9800X 3D, I'm guessing, and a 9070 XT. So your GPU is gonna have the greatest impact on your gaming performance, the amount of frames that your system can actually produce, that is, assuming it's not being held back by a very slow CPU. The CPU, and also potentially the memory, would be the second tier of things that affects your performance. SSD actually doesn't typically affect game performance. It can affect how quickly a game loads up, but once the game is loaded into system memory, the SSD is pretty much removed from the equation. So it is somewhat important, but doesn't affect performance as directly. So my recommendation for you would be to look at a Ryzen 5 option like a 7600, 7600X, maybe even the 9600 if the prices are reasonable there. That should cost you in the low $200 range, and that will be for a 6-core CPU. The step up from there would be to jump up to an 8-core Ryzen 7. Of course, the best possible option is the 9800X 3D right now. That will give you 8 cores, which will give you a bit more CPU horsepower for encoding on the fly or doing video editing after the fact, for example. But always remember that you can upgrade. So I would be looking closely at the GPU prices and what price you can actually find a Radeon 9070 XT for. Note that they are very overpriced right now, and I would not recommend one of these for $850 or $900. For that price, in the current market, you should be opting for the 5070 Ti, in my humble opinion. Regardless of which of the GPU SKUs you go for though, you're gonna see a huge boost and improvement from your RTX 2060 6 gig, so that's pretty cool. And then to answer your final extra question, for Windows, for a person who's building a gaming rig, does Pro or Home version matter? The Home version of Windows 11 should work just fine for most gaming PCs out there. The Pro version gives you a little bit more advanced networking, so if you're gonna join a network domain or something like that, you might wanna opt for Pro. But I would say when you're doing the installation, just keep in mind, I'm actually going to be buying a Windows license to plug in. Sometimes the Pro versions cost just as much as the Home versions, in which case I'd say just go for Pro. Or you could do the simple thing that a lot of people do, which is to install Windows, not activate it, and just live with the watermark down in the corner, and then you have a free operating system. More money to spend on your overpriced GPU, I assume. But guys, that's gonna wrap it up for this episode of Probing Paul, and next month, I'm gonna do Probing Paul, or maybe even later this month since it's the beginning of May, but I'd like to do Probing Paul and Mail Time together. So if you have anything non-toxic and non-lethal that you'd like to send over, send it to this P.O. Box, Paul's Hardware P.O. Box 4325. That is also linked in the video's description, and perhaps I will open it on the next episode. But guys, that's gonna wrap it up for Probing Paul, episode number 93. Thank you once again for your comments. I hope you've learned a little bit from my answers. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you're not already for more videos coming at you real soon, and we'll see you all in the next one.